editing. After hours filming, you, the editor, will take the footage and craft the story from the greatest moments, making a watchable experience for your audience. There is no right way to edit, but only one main rule: to create a natural energy and pace while providing details for the story to make sense. So to maintain that energy and convey that information, there are a couple of techniques that you need to know in order to make your edits amazing. Hi, I'm Tom from FXhome, and if you're new to editing, I highly recommend you checking out our free editor, HitFilm Express. And it's worthwhile checking out our Basics Masterclass as well, where you'll learn the workspace and tools needed to create your videos in the best way possible. Now, let's go over the essential cuts that every editor should know. Standard. This is your super simple, straightforward cut. Placing two clips either side of each other and snapping them together like Legos. Easy, no fuss, no flair, but completely necessary for your edit. It's essentially your bread and butter. You can actually make that snapping a lot more effective as well if you use the ripple delete. All you have to do is right-click the gap in the timeline and go up to ripple delete. Ripple delete will actually eliminate all the empty frames, so there's no guesswork, there's no worry of just random flashy frames. Straightforward, to the point, cut. The jump cut. You will see a lot of YouTubers doing jump cuts. I'm actually doing one right now. It's the process of having one long continuous take, trimming the fat, making the pace quicker, snappy, easy, and to the point. Imagine what it's like to keep all the breaks and pauses. It can sometimes feel very awkward and uncomfortable, so jump cuts eliminate all the dead space. Use the audio waveform as your guide, grab the slice tool by hitting C, get those gaps out of there, and ripple delete the gaps. The J cut. You will actually see these everywhere you go from this point onwards. Getting its name from the shape that it makes on the timeline, the J cut is the step up from your standard. Imagine two clips, A and B. Now, by introducing the audio from clip B a couple of seconds earlier, while clip A is still playing, this will create a smooth transition into your next scene. J cuts create a sense of intrigue about what's about to come. So ask yourself, what is about to feature in the next take or scene? The seaside, rain. By introducing that familiar sound, you are piquing the interest of your audience. These are great for conversational pieces, voiceover, and transitions between location. So if you're finding that the standard cut is a little bit too harsh, try a J cut. The L cut. Now that you know what a J cut is, take it, flip it around, you got yourself an L cut. These may not be used as much as a J cut, but in conversational pieces, they are vital. By doing this, the editor is allowing the audience to hear the dialogue while seeing the reaction of a character, giving the audience a better overall understanding of what's happening in the scene. See it as J cuts are to lead into the next thing, while L cuts are reactionary to what's just happened. I mean, what do you think? Does that make sense? You can even make an L or a J cut by holding Alt and dragging your clip's image or audio, stretching it any way you want. Cutting on action. Cutting on action is the approach where we kind of hide our cuts. Using the camera or actor's motion, we are trying to hide any cuts very seamlessly. Punches being thrown is a good example. Running, you use their momentum to hide and mask the edit. The cut will often go unnoticed because the audience will be paying attention to the motion on screen. Cross-cutting. Cross-cutting is as it sounds. You're switching back and forth between scenes to give the impression that the action is occurring in two separate locations and unfolding at the exact same time. Usually the two narratives will then collide.
Hey guys, if you're enjoying the video, why don't you subscribe to the channel and give this video a like? It really helps us out.
When did you leave? Thanks, Ollie. Christopher Nolan films in particular have a great use of cross-cutting. Inception and Dunkirk in particular heavily feature huge sequences that are part of the same story or event, but over different times. Parallel editing. There is an argument to be made whether this can also be considered as cross-cutting, but I'm going to call it parallel cutting. This is usually character-driven and designed to illustrate the differences between two opposing characters, often your antagonist and protagonist, or the loose cannon cops that can't see eye to eye but will eventually learn to love each other like brothers. This method works in a way that is designed to compare and contrast the image. Cutaways. The cutaway is just that. It cuts away from the main story to provide some visual information. occurring anywhere in relation to your scene, and not really having any strict geological requirements. These can really help you out when you're in the editing room and may have come across some complications on set. Cutaways are particularly great for documentaries and interviews if you want to try and tie in different conversations that were happening over different time periods. So when you come back from a shoot and you have all that B-roll just lying around, put it to good use with a cutaway. Montage! If you have a character that's on a mission to change, you need a montage. Montages help communicate a large amount of information to an audience over a shorter span of time by juxtaposing different shots, compressing the time through editing, or intertwining multiple storylines of a narrative. Most famous for training and travel sequences, but done right, you can tell a narrative spanning over years in no time at all. The match cut. A match cut is an edit that is focused in on the cinematography, using elements from one scene to move into another. The purpose is to have a visual match for two different scenes that may not inherently actually have a link, like locations. We've covered the match cut in our seamless transitions tutorial, and if you want to learn more about transitions and how to pull them off in your edit, I highly recommend you going to check that out. The Wanna, no cut, cheat cut. Not really a cheat, but it does allow the editor to relax a little bit and allow some time and breathing space. The editor then passes on to the audience. You are now able to pick and choose where you're going to focus and what you're going to look at, as there's nothing to cut away to or from, no different takes, just one continuous moment. Feels weird. Doing a wanna always comes down to planning in pre-production, so that is something that can't really be helped in post-production. And in recent years, filmmakers have been experimenting more and more with how to do a one take for a feature-length film, such as Birdman, Silent House, and 1917, to name a few. I think that might be all of them. Now that we've covered the type of cuts, let's answer the big question. How do you know when to cut? The short answer is instinct. I know. Now that you know these essential cuts, it's all down to you to experiment and play with them. You'll eventually develop a sense of pacing and timing and a gut reaction of when and how to use these different techniques. Practice makes perfect and is the greatest way for you to master your craft. So open up HitFilm and get slicing. We really enjoy making these type of videos for you guys. If there is a topic that you would like us to cover in future, let us know in the comment section down below and we will be sure to get on it right away. I will make it my mission to answer that. Till next time, don't forget to like and subscribe, and we will see you in the next tutorial.